Yo, Aaron. Yo, where are we going?
We're going to Fuji Q Highland. Let's go, boys.
2 hours later.
We made it. Fuji Q Highland. All right, so me and my friend Aaron here, we are here at Fuji Q Highland today. This has been one of my bucket list parks for years. They got Fujiyama right behind me, and then Ajinaika is the other big one that I want to ride. This park is like widely known for being the most crowded amusement park in probably the world. So we're gonna see. Hopefully we don't wait in too many lines, but I am so pumped to be here today. We are inside Fuji Q Highland now, and this is the one that I came to ride, Ajinaika. This thing looks absolutely insane. It's known to be one of the most intense roller coasters in the world. I'm pumped for it. Aaron, what do you think?
This place is looking crazy, guys. I'm ready to ride some rides. Let's go.
Oh yeah, and the line's only 30 minutes long. Fujiyama right behind me is already at 50 minutes, and then the new one that just opened in July, Zokan, I don't really know. It's at 2 hours, so maybe we'll skip that one for right now. This thing is nuts.
Oh my. That is insane.
Crazy. 70 minute wait. We got our fries. They're playing the Ajinaika song. I'm ready for it. You can't have anything. No tickets, no watches, no shoes.
No service, what's up? No service.
Oh, can't you read? No shirt, no shoes, no service. State law.
Ajinaika review. We just got off that. Holy shit. That was exactly like X2 at Magic Mountain, but more intense in every single way. It's smoother, better, faster. That thing was just crazy. Aaron, what'd you think?
That was crazy, honestly. That was an insane ride. I respected it a lot.
Yeah, like after that ride, I couldn't stop laughing. I was out of breath. Here's to some more rides. We're gonna go check out the rest of the ones here. We're gonna do another lap, and then I wanna come back and ride Ajinaika again. No, the roller coaster's closed. Anyways, look at that thing. That thing looks crazy. It's like a sideways Ferris wheel. This park is so strange, but so cool. Then there's Ajinaika again.
Best ride ever.
You think so? Is that your
Very
new number
fun.
One?
Very fun so far, number one.
What'd you think?
Good ride. I would say, honestly, solid 9. Very fun ride. Very
Do you
fun
think
ride.
This is better or Ajinaika is better?
I actually like this one better, but both rides are solid.
We just got off Takabisha here. This is the world's steepest roller coaster. It's actually tied for steepest roller coaster in the world with one at Nick Universe called Shellraiser. I've been on that one so many times and not a huge fan of it. This one was much smoother though. Wait time was only about 30 minutes, so not bad there. Seemed to run a little bit faster. Big fan, actually. We got the crepe and Aaron with the ice cream. So as you can see, this white roller coaster right here is Dodo Donpa. And then right behind the Ferris wheel is a big loop. This has been closed for 2 years now. And the reason Dodo Donpa is closed is it broke someone's back, like legitimately snapped their back. It is the world's fastest accelerating roller coaster. It goes something like 0 to 118 in 1.3 seconds. Absolutely absurd. It does not get crazier than that. Fujiyama, king of coasters. This thing built in 1996, 27 years old now. It looks absolutely ginormous. Kind of scared for this one. We just got off Fujiyama. That was crazy for no good reason whatsoever.
1996 roller coaster, amazing.
Yeah, dude, that thing had so much airtime. It was so jerky. It was so awful that it was incredible. Like one of those things. Those last few hills, Aaron, I was actually like scared for my life. I was slipping like out of the restraint, like
same.
Almost onto you. It was really bad. But that one was so good. So good. And I've heard really bad things about other Togos, so I'm happy it was good. As for right now, it's starting to rain a little bit, so we're gonna see if the rides stay open or not. If they do though, going back to Ijanaika. Just as we got off Fujiyama, it started pouring out here. I'm really glad I'm not on there in the pouring rain. We had a really good ride though. But Jesus Christ. I wonder if they're still dry. How you feeling?
All right. Wet. Adrenaline went crazy earlier. Great time though.
Aaron's ready for a nap too. So it's currently raining on us. We're gonna go see if we can maybe ride the Ferris wheel right now. It's still moving and the cars look like they're indoors and I think there's people on it, so.
Dodo Donpa and Asian Nike over there. We got Aaron here.
So
we're in the Ferris wheel. You got Takabisha and Fujiyama too. Still raining, but what a nice view. And we're dry inside. I mean, this place is pretty cozy.
At this point, all the major rides have been closed for about 2 hours now. The rain was still coming down pretty hard, and the whole park was emptying out. The Ferris wheel, which was the only ride still open, is about 160 feet tall. It looked pretty rusty, but it gave some great views of the park as well as the backdrop of Mount Fuji. Even though it was pouring, we had still ridden all three major roller coasters once, so I couldn't complain at all.
Okay, so it's 3:30 right now. Aaron is heading back to Tokyo.
Hi guys.
I am staying here because I'm crazy like that, and I'm gonna see if I can ride anything else. Fujiyama's going, I saw Ijanaika's going up the lift right now, Dodo Donpa still hasn't gone in like 2 years. We're gonna see what I can ride before it starts pouring again. So the new coaster over there is still at an hour and 20, but Ijanaika's going. Honestly, I'd wait 2 hours for this thing. The line is long and I think it's gonna rain again, so I'm paying for a fast pass. Totally just paid $17 to skip the 100 minute wait, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna pour within the next like 20, 30 minutes, so I'm riding this.
Oh yeah.
$17 and I skipped a 2 hour line and walked right on front row. That was incredible. So this is one train now and that line is crazy. I got some beautiful views. That was absolutely insane. So I have two questions. Was it worth it to pay $17 just to ride this once? Yes. Second question is, how many times am I gonna do it?
This is like gambling, but worse.
Let's go.
Absolutely crazy. There's like 6 seatbelts on this thing too.
Ride number 2, I'm like $40 in the hole just for Ijanaika. I got row 3, I got an outside seat though, so pick and choose your battles. That was incredible. Genuinely, I'm still at a loss for words. I think for right now, I'm gonna call my, not my losses, but stop hurting my wallet. Ijanaika hasn't run since my last ride, but there is a new coaster that I haven't been on, new for this year. 90 minute wait. Man, I wish there was, wait a second. What's this? Is this what I think it is? Huh. Duck On is their new motorbike coaster. That thing was a ton of fun. It goes backwards. There's like three launches. Way better than I was expecting. It's like a mini Hagrid's from Universal. Yeah, no, I'm happy with that. And I'm happy I paid $20 to skip that line too. The line on this thing was not moving. Like at all. Like, holy crap, I skipped the whole line and I still waited about 15 minutes for it.
Okay, so that weather doesn't look good.
Luckily, by the time it was my turn to get on, I was in row 2 waiting for the train to return, and the weather was still holding off.
A few minutes later...
I have no words for what just happened. Look at this. How bad is it? Bad? Oh my god. I was in the second row. It's pouring outside. It's bad. Oh my god. There is not a single dry spot on here at all.
After about 15 seconds on the lift hill, the rain started absolutely pouring.
Everywhere is soaked.
For the whole 3 minutes and 30 seconds, I was drenched.
Okay, so I'm cold, I'm wet. I booked a bus ticket this morning for 8:20 after the park closed at 8, and it's currently 6:52, so I'm like, might as well stick around. Aaron is still in the bus. 3 hours later, I guess the rush hour traffic was pretty bad. Honestly, I'm just kind of hoping one more ride opens up for the end of the night. If not though, I got my rides on everything. I'm pretty content.
Well, there's one ride open and I don't think there's a line, so.
Okay, so the sign says, please use a poncho for 200 yen.
Let's go. Okay. I don't know what this is, but where's my poncho? So I hand this ticket up there and they give me a poncho for this.
Alright, you know we got that paycheck. That Rapids ride, pretty crazy. There were 3 drops on it, one of which sent me like spinning down this spiral thing. I thought I was gonna fall out, but let me just say that was the best $1.32 I've ever spent buying a poncho. I would have gotten drenched all over again. Would have been like my Fujiyama rain ride. Now it's like 7:10, so I've done enough stalling. I'm making my way back to Agent Ica, and I hear the chain lift going, so I'm gonna see how long the line is and judge from there, but I think I need to ride.
Holy
Agent Ica is a walk-on. Oh my god. This is crazy. I'm gonna die. Goodbye, Agent Ica. Goodbye. Okay, so just as I went to get back on Agent Ica, they closed the ride, which I'm okay with. The ops were kind of taking a while, and I don't really want to miss my bus. It's in 30 minutes. So I'm gonna start making my way to the front of the park. Honestly, I couldn't have asked for a better last memory here at Fuji Q Highland. I got front row on Agent Ica at night, outside seat, with some crazy guy next to me. He was like screaming in Japanese, like throwing his hands up, fist bumping me. It was an incredible ride and one that I'm gonna really remember. Especially after the day I had, I didn't pay 20 bucks for that one. It stopped raining, it opened within the last hour. Like, I have gotten so lucky today, even after my row 2 rain ride on Fujiyama, that I am still really wet from. And that's gonna be it for Fuji Q Highland here with their Eiffel Tower in the back. Thank you guys for following along this vlog. I am so lucky that I got to have the day that I had today. With all the rain and what I've heard about this park being super crowded, I think I did really well. I only had to buy 3 fast passes and it was all worth it. And then I rode everything I wanted to, the big roller coasters. There were just 2 roller coasters that were closed, but honestly, I don't really care. I had such a great time. And then the rain ride on Fujiyama in row 2, that was crazy. And the last ride on Agent Ica, this day was perfect. So thank you guys again for watching. I will see you all in the next vlog. Peace out, guys.